What's up, guys? Nepenthes here, and welcome to This Is How We FIFA. This is actually an episode of Ruin a Randomer. And before you say anything, I know I need to get some lighting in this room that doesn't make me look like Casper the motherfucking ghost. It's ridiculous. Anyways, after the patch, the game has changed a little bit. I'm going to show you guys how I play FIFA now and still get wins. It's not really a good style of football, in my opinion, but it's a good way to play. So I'm going to talk about it through Ruin a Randomer. Before we get into the actual game and the gameplay, I just want to show you something or tell you something from the EA forums, from Rob Hodson's update patch note post. Issues address reads: gameplay improvements to defensive positioning and lob through balls. Coupled with that, there was a thread in the forums about the patch and about how everyone was hating the patch. Some of you like the patch, I particularly don't. And Rob Hodson addressed that thread, closed it, and left this in the comments. Hi guys, this thread and the other threads have certainly been made for interesting reads. To clarify a few things, however, the only gameplay changes in this patch were regarding defensive positioning and the accuracy of lob through balls. For the positioning, there was a change so that from kickoff, if someone ran towards your goal, forwards and midfielders will drop back. Your defenders will now also hold better positions. Strictly position changes, however. For the lob through balls, there was a scenario where they were too accurate. They're now less so. That's it. No changes to passing, dribbling, tackle skills, or anything else. Banter. Top class banter from Rob Hodson there. Anyway, guys, let's get into the game and talk a little bit more about how to win in this patch. Okay, guys, today's opponent is an 83 rated 100 chem team. He's got a Brazilian trio up front there. A lot of pace there from that Brazilian trio. He's got Iniesta, Xavi, Busquets in midfield. That's actually a really nice hybrid. Alba and De Marcos. Is that De Marcos? It's not De Marcos, is it? It might be, I don't know. And then Boateng, Benatia and Reina, really tidy hybrid. So, we're talking about this game and how to win in this game. And I want to give Rob Hodson the benefit of the doubt. I want to believe that the only thing they've changed is defensive positioning and the accuracy of lob through balls. Supposedly, they are now less effective, the accuracy of through balls, right? On a game that I played yesterday for the best team in FIFA, after I read that, I thought, let me try lob through balls to test out if they are less accurate or more accurate, basically, because I don't really play chip through balls anyway. But I got to be honest, they are 100% not less accurate. If they are less accurate now, I can't even begin to imagine how accurate they were before, because it's like, honestly, now look at that chip through ball for him. It goes through straight away. First chip through ball is done. We're not going to really try and focus on the lob through balls. However, talking in this video, I want to tell you guys how to play FIFA. So how do you play FIFA now? The best way to play is to literally spam chip through balls. You're going to see a few times in this video, in this game, my opponent, my own players, there's a chip through ball that's accurate. When they play a hand forwards, look at that, Robin, chip through balls. Guys, they have been nerfed. Don't worry about it. They've been nerfed. Okay, I didn't score from that chip through ball there. But, you know, it still hit Robin's feet. This is the only way to play. And the reason why I think that is, I was watching back some of my old games. There's a chip through ball for you. Is he going to get it? Oh, keeper makes a big save. Courtois with a big save there. I was trying to look back at my games and think, like, right, what's different here? What is different, guys? You know, I need to figure out how the only thing that's different is defensive positioning. And whilst a lot of people are having problems with passing now and with, like, silly errors within the game that weren't in the game before, I believe that chip through balls, I don't believe chip through balls have been nerfed. I believe that defensive positioning has been the only thing that's been changed. And the reason why that's important, apparently the skill dribble was still in there. Apparently, you know, the passing is the same. I can believe that. I just also believe that the new defensive positioning, as we get another accurate chip through ball there, the new defensive positioning is what's caused all of these things to go wrong. Okay, so before, what would happen? You would, oh shit, that was nice. If I lose this game whilst talking about how to win this game, that would be embarrassing, wouldn't it? Let's just ping one. Let's see what happens. Oh wow, it went over. So now the defensive line that you play against now backs off, like just automatically. That's what they mean with the new defensive positioning. It's genuinely like that you're on park the bus constantly. Even if you're not on park the bus, like look at his defensive line, look how deep it is. I'm not saying he's on park the bus, he's most likely not on park the bus. All I'm saying is the defensive positioning is now reworked to the point where the defenders just back off, which isn't exactly how real life football works. I'm not saying they should always lunge in. All I'm saying is they shouldn't always back off. And I personally feel like instead of EA changing the defensive positioning. They should have left it how it was, because previously you had to... there's a chip through ball. Oh, that was almost through. Thank God my defender got in the way. So, yeah, previously you actually had to defend with skill. It required skill for you to defend. And oh, there's a chip through ball for me. Is he going to make it? No. Yeah, it required skill to defend. If you know, you had to defend many types of attacks, whether it be skill runs, whether it be passing, whether it be dribbles, whether it be chip through balls, whether it be crossing. There was many things to consider when somebody had the ball at their feet, when your opponent had the ball at his feet. There was many things to consider whilst defending. Now there's one thing to consider whilst defending, because the defense backs off so much that all you have to look at now is, hey, how do I stop the chip through balls? And that's exactly what I did there. One chip through ball, and I didn't manage to score from it because I was trying to be cocky scoring. But yeah, one chip through ball, and we got through on goal there with Eden Hazard. Couldn't make anything of it. See how my defensive line is backing off and backing off? Before the patch, that didn't happen. They wouldn't back off like that. They wouldn't necessarily push up, but they wouldn't back off, you know? So there was some differences there. So I try and think, right, how do we play this game? Right, there's another chip through ball. And like I say, the fact that the defense backs off so much doesn't allow you to pass the ball properly, because there's no more passing avenues. Because if you pass it into your midfield, the defense has backed off so much that the only thing you can do, that's a really nice turn, he's missed it, holy crap. The only thing you can do when they back off is either walk up with it, wait for the run for the chip through ball, or pass it back to your defense, because there's no pressure now. The fact that the defense isn't causing any pressure has ruined the passing, and that's why people are having problems with passing, I believe. I'm trying to look at this from Rob Hodgson's point of view. I'm trying to think to myself, how is this the only thing that's changed? In terms of the skill dribbles, once again, pre-patch, if you pick the ball up with your striker and you run at a defender, they wouldn't back off. You know, they would just stay in one position, or you know, you would be forced to control them. They would stay in one place, and you'd be able to actually dribble around them. Now, because of this new defensive positioning, oh shit, I think I've just passed that straight to him. Oh, thank God for that. Now, because of the new defensive positioning, they back off so deeply that even if you run towards them, eventually you're gonna basically be auto-tackled. Look at that chip through ball, boom. Love that. Space and some pace. Yeah, eventually you're basically fucked. Eventually. Oh my God, I'm trying too much. I'm trying too much in the attacking section. So yeah, the bottom line is, whether or not chip through balls have been nerfed or buffed is irrelevant. The reason why, in my opinion, looking at this subjectively, the reason why people think that they've been buffed rather than nerfed is because it's the only style of play you can actually play now. Skill runs, they've been taken away because of this new defensive positioning. Passing has been taken away because of this new defensive positioning. The only thing that's available to people is chip through balls. Or maybe crossing. Like, crossing has come back a little bit. Again, they say they haven't buffed headers. They haven't buffed crossing. It's exactly the same. Why does it feel like we have... Look at that. Chip through ball. Like, it's just making my point there. He didn't end up scoring from it. But, again, he plays a chip through ball. He makes a success of it. No problem at all. Just easy success. It's crazy. It's, like, literally crazy how easy it is for people to pop chip through balls over the top. And it's not... I don't believe it's because... I'm losing my train of thought. I don't believe it's because they're buffed now. Although I kind of do believe it's because they've been buffed. But, you know, if Rob Hodgson said they haven't been, then, hey, they mustn't have been. I believe it's because the way the new defense works, you have no alternative other than to play chip through balls. It's like they've taken away all the fun aspects of attacking in this game and made the defending so easy that you just can't, you're forced to play one-dimensional FIFA. And I think that's where the problem lies for everyone. This guy's a pretty good player. Like, when he gets the ball with his attackers, he tries skill moves and stuff. He can't do anything with it. Why can't he do anything with it? Because the defense backs off so much. Previously, the defense would push up and try and nab him, try and get the ball from him. One of his skill moves, he would have got past my defender, he would have been clean through on goal. Now, the only chances he's created have been from when he's played a chip through ball and it's got through on goal. So I'm not sure if other things have changed purposely. I think they've changed inadvertently due to the fact that the way this goes now is through defenses backing off and backing off, that you have no other alternative. The other thing, so a video was brought to my attention yesterday. about a guy who was in Division 1 and was basically playing a guy in Division 3, which, you know, just... Oh crap. I'm running the player off the pitch, holy shit. Which confirms my my theory about, you know, the ELO system and so on and so forth. And basically, he didn't defend when he had the ball. Is that not... Yeah, that is a free kick. What happens is, when he didn't have the ball, he didn't as much as put his control down as just not do anything other than run back with the player. So from now on, see how I have the player here? It auto-switched me to the defender once I get in an area where I have the ball. So if you want to defend well, if you want to defend really good to the point where you're going to frustrate your opponent, all you have to do is not do anything. The player you've got the ball with, just run back and let the AI defend for you. Because this, again, with this new defensive positioning, and the only thing I feel like they've definitely 100% changed is the auto-tackling within the defenders. Because they can't not have changed this. Like, the auto-tackling's too good now. It's too strong. Holy shit, what the fuck is that? It's too good and too strong now that I can't believe that they haven't done anything with it. I didn't mean to play that ball. That was supposed to go to Eden Hazard. So now I'm defending. You see, I'm running back with Hazard. Obviously, I'm not winning this game. I'm really trying to like talk about the game and show you things within the game. See how he's being marked by the defender because of the new defensive positioning? I did nothing to get that ball back. I literally just run around with Robben. And again, I'm going to run around. It auto-switches me, which means I have the favour for the ball. I have the position for the ball. And now I get through on goal and bang, chip through balls. They've been nerfed. It's no problem. And once again, I have the ball. See how I'm not doing anything? It's auto-switched me to a defender. He's going to be offside. I get the ball back, auto-switches me. I'm literally doing nothing to defend. And that's because of this new defensive positioning system. Once again, I'm not touching the ball. I'm not touching it. I'm doing nothing. As soon as I get possession of the ball back, it auto-switches me to the player in question who's actually got the ball, and bang, I come away with it. Again, I've done nothing to defend. I've literally have done absolutely nothing for that, yet I have the ball back. How is that fun to play? I'm not saying, like, this is what I say why I don't like the patch. I'm not saying I enjoy this patch. I'm not saying I enjoy playing like this. I'm saying this is the way you have to play. This is what you have to do because the game is so bland now, so dry, that you don't really have any other choices. Oh, that should have been a goal. Once again, I've lost the ball. See who I'm running back with. I'm pointing, you can't see. I'm running back with the striker. I'm running back with Hazard here. He takes a long shot because my defense backs off for me. My defense defended for me. What they've done by changing this defensive positioning is removed 50% of this game. You no longer have to defend anymore. You can let the AI defend for you. And that's basically it. They've ruined the game. They've let the AI defend for you. Oh, Robben. Go, Robben. Oh, he's missed it. I think that's my first shot. They've let the AI defend for you. Attacking is so boring now because your opponent's AI is defending for him. So you're basically left in this conundrum. See how we're 0-0? This guy's had a few shots because he's had a lot of long shots. Once again, I know I'm winning that ball because it auto-switched the defender for me. This guy's had a lot of long shots, okay? Which is why he's had so many shots. But this game has been boring. All he's been reduced to is a couple of chip through balls and a couple of long shots. He's had nothing else. And look at my defense. Look at how they're backing off. How is this fun? How is this fun to play? It's not fun to play, but we don't have any other alternatives because this game is so dry right now. What a save from the keeper. This game is so dry right now because they've taken all the fun out of it by making it a 50% play game. All you do now with this new patch is attack. You don't have to defend. The AI will defend for you. You literally... What the fuck was that? Is he offside? Why did my defender back off of that? No, don't keep that in. Let it go out. Oh, that's right. No, keep it in. Well done. Yeah, you literally don't have to do anything anymore. The AI does everything for you to the point where defending is boring and attacking is boring because defending is boring. Once again, I can't reiterate enough. You don't have to defend. I won't control a defender. Look at my defensive line. It's just backing off and backing off. It's got him to a position where the only thing he can do is chip it. And so he chips it. Okay, that one wasn't accurate enough. This is how EA have ruined this game. This is exactly how they've ruined this game. It's because what they've done is made it easy, so easy for you to defend the ball. Is that fun? It's not fun. Is that how you have to play? It's how you have to play to win this game. You can you can pass it. You can dribble with it. But it's difficult. It's not easy, that's for sure. You can play whatever style of FIFA you want to play. And I'm sure there's some people out there that are going to look at this video and think, nah, you're wrong. Oh, he's left me a good gap there. People out there are going to think, nope, you're 100% wrong. You can play this game exactly how it was pre-patch. Some people love this game since the patch, and that's because it suits them to not have to defend. The skill cap in defending is gone. The skill cap in this FIFA is gone. Look at that. He's resorted again to another chip through ball because he had nothing else available to him, because my defense is so good, because it just backs off and backs off. Okay, I've fucked up there. I've ended up, look at that. The AI defended for me again. I get the ball back again. Did I earn the ball? Of course I didn't. The fucking AI defended it for me. I didn't do shit for this. I literally didn't do shit for this. And here we go. Chip through ball. Chip through ball's been nerfed, guys. That's a foul. That's a foul, ref. That's got to be a foul. We get a corner out of that. Once again, I just wanted to play a game to show. I haven't really attacked very well this game because I wanted to show more about the defensive ability and how it's affected the game. But you can see clear as day, when I'm not in possession of the ball, I'm not doing anything. I'm not doing anything. Literally, I'm just running back with the player I have, cutting off maybe a pass avenue here or there, but pretty much not doing anything, right? Oh, that was a bad pass. You know, I literally don't have to defend. The AI defends for me, which is why I haven't really attacked very well. I'm trying to focus and show you guys what the difference is with this defensive positioning. Look at Rob M there. He makes the run. The chip through ball, didn't manage to get through. Okay, defending again. He's on the ball. Look at my defense. They're just backing off. And again, it's going to resort to him either chipping the ball or having a long shot. There you go, he chips it because he's got no other alternative, and that's why this game is now bad. Not because of, maybe they haven't reduced the dribbling. Maybe they haven't changed the passing. I can understand slightly how they can, you know, how people can think that. Wow, they still fucked the offside shit. I can still understand slightly how they can say, yeah, we haven't changed anything. But what I don't understand is why they've changed it to the point where by doing what they've done, they have ruined every single style of football you can play other than a chip through ball or long shots. Keepers are fucked, so if you do have long shots, you actually might have a chance. You might have a chance. That's a great save from the keeper. You know, if you, like I say, if you do a long shot here or there, you potentially could have a chance. But ultimately, this game has gone from a fantasy game that was entertaining to play. Yeah, there was a lot of goals, and that's because people had to manually defend. There was a lot of goals because you had to manually defend. Now, look at that, 0-0. All right, he's had a lot of shots. Has he had any shots from inside my box? He's had 4 shots from inside my box, and look at where some of those shots are from. They're literally almost at the halfway line because he has no other alternative, because the defending is so strong now. They've literally gone from what some people will think is at one extreme to another. It's gone from being impossible to defend to being impossible to score. It's just not fun. It's just not fun. We're going to spend the rest of this game trying to actually get goals now. We're going to try and attack. Once again, though, when you watch me defend, just watch. Look at the player I'm controlling. It's in the middle. Only when it auto-switches me will I be controlling someone else. And the only reason why it will auto-switch me is because they are 100% guaranteed to get that ball back. He's ended up scoring an absolutely fantastic goal. He's scored a brilliant goal there. Again, long shots. Eventually, a long shot is going to go in. That was actually just a really nice goal. Ronaldo chops past the defender. Has a bang. Goes in the back of the net. No problem. I'm going to try and stop talking about the game now and try and actually play into the game. Like I said, I'm going to try and play to score. But because of the way this game is now, it's so difficult to actually score goals, because the only thing you can do is chip through ball. So now I'm going to actually start pressing him. I'm going to try and, like I said, I'm going to try and get the ball back. There's a lovely through ball. Oh, is that a foul, ref? Oh, we're nearly there. See, I'm actually literally, I'm going to start second man pressing this guy now as well, because which is a bad thing for me to do. It could mean that I end up conceding more because I'm manually defending now, and that's not exactly the best thing to do. But this game at 1-0, is a boring game. 1-0 in extra time as well, guys. It's taken us to extra time to get that goal. He might score again. Like I said, he's had another long shot. Most of his shots have been long shots, which is, you know, it's a problem. It's definitely a problem in this game. Most of his shots have been long shots. He's had a couple from inside the box. Most of them have been long shots. The only thing I can do is chip through ball it, because you see his defense, he's had another long shot there. The keeper's tipped it over, and this is what I mean with the long shots. Keepers are going to tip it over. I'm probably going to lose this game. Like I said, I spent a lot of this game purposely not attacking, but, you know, trying to actually show you guys what the differences were within the game. Hazard's never going to get onto that. I'm gonna go attacking now. See if we can. I need to get some men up, some men forwards. Right, Robben, run. There we go. Robben's run. Chip through ball's on. Robben gets the chip through ball, and then he loses the ball. What's he lost the ball for? Oh shit! I've won it back. Oh, I've lost it again. Wow, how the fuck did he even get through that? That's a great tackle. Sometimes manually defending is better. Sometimes it's not better. This is an instance where it has been better for me, because otherwise he would have probably been through on goal there. He's going to get a cross in. Wow, I managed to get away with that. What are we in? We're 105th minute. So we're half time and extra time. I'm not even mad that I'm losing this game, because I haven't, like, I've been focusing so much. Like, I've had two shots, you know, like this obviously isn't the way I would typically play FIFA. Having two shots, I'm very, you know, I'm very an attacking person anyway. But let's see if we can actually get through here. Can't get through. I just can't get through. And why can't I get through? Because his defense just backs off and backs off and backs off, and is ruined, in my opinion. Everything that I loved about this game. There we go. See what the defender did there? A chip through ball. The defender ends up running up the field. And this is a problem. This was shown in the guy's video where he showed that he didn't defend. He showed his opponent where he played a chip through ball, and his opponent's defender stepped up. You know, why would your defender step up? You don't want your defender to step up. You want them to stay back. You definitely want them to stay back. Why do you want them to stay back? Because otherwise you're fucked. Because otherwise, oh, come on, let's get this. I can't do it. I don't have enough men forward. I'm even on ultra attacking. Let's see if we can get the ball back. That's a lovely bit of pressure there. Let's see if we can get this in. No, not to him. Not to him. Why not to the man in the space? This is where this game fucks me off sometimes. And now he's going to have another opportunity to attack. We're actually in a bit of trouble here. I don't think I'm going to win this game. I don't really care that I don't win this game. This is more about showing you. Unfortunately, this is supposed to be showing you how to play FIFA, but I've been unable to do so because I've been trying to explain to you about the defensive and the changes. But this is basically how you have to play FIFA. Now, look at this guy. He's just playing super, super fucking sweaty. Oh, wow. Can we get a break on? We need to get away. We need to get away from his defense. Look how his defense backs off, though. Can't do anything with it. Can't do anything. Managed to get through finally. Here we go. Oh my God. Hazard stopped on the ball there. Just need to get in. Oh, his keeper saves it. 118th minute. We end up going to lose this game. Don't really care that we lose the game. Like I said, this is more about showing you guys. Oh shit. Showing you guys what's what. This guy has created all of his attacks. That's going to be a free kick, isn't it? Fuck. This guy has created all of his attacks through chip through balls and through nothing else. He scored his goal from a long shot. This game has been so boring to play. And it's not his fault, and it's not my fault. It's EA's fault for changing the defensive style to the point where, oh my God, oh my God, who is that? Courtois, how do you just not save that? Yeah, it's changed the game to the point where you just don't have to defend. And now it's gone from a game where we could have scored three or four goals and maybe conceded one or two goals to a game that finishes 1-0 in after extra time, no less, because of how boring the game is. I can appreciate a lot of people in the comment section are going to give me, oh, you lost your teacher telling us how to play, you lost. I get that. I get the irony in the fact that this video is called How to FIFA. But actually, his attacking style and my defensive style is the perfect combination. What he's done in attack has proved that the only way you can generally create chances now is through either long shots or chip through balls. There is no other alternative. And I proved defensively that by doing nothing, you can stomp out 99% of your opponent's attacks. It's just a ridiculous way to play FIFA. EA with this have ruined the game because they've made it so easy to defend. He ended up having a hell of a lot of shots to my two shots. I wasn't really playing seriously, you know, like if I was playing seriously, I would have been getting so much, like if for those of you that have seen me in Ruin of Randomers before and know how mad I get at this game, I would have been fucking fuming at this game by this point. I was trying to show and prove a point, and I feel like I proved that point. He had a lot of shots. Look at where his shots are from, because he was left with nothing. So many chip through balls. If EA have reduced the accuracy of chip through balls, then before this new defensive style, they must have been absolutely incredible, but they weren't abused because you didn't have to play with chip through balls. Now, there's two ways to play this game. You shoot from long range or you chip it. So even if they've nerfed the accuracy of chip through balls, because now people are so intent on playing chip through balls because it's one of the only ways to play this game, you're gonna see more chip through balls connecting and more chip through balls connecting, and there's just nothing you can do about it. So I don't know if EA ever want to watch this video, if they'll ever watch this video. I don't know if you guys agree or disagree. If you agree, obviously leave a like on the video. If you disagree, let me know in the comment section how you feel about this game. For a lot of you, this is exactly how FIFA 14 was. That's how this game was. It was based largely around chipping the ball and crossing the ball. There was not really anything else, which is why that's what everyone did. Pre-patch, this game was perfect. It required skill to defend, it required skill to attack. Now, it requires no skill to defend, and it requires no skill to attack. And that's what the major issue with this patch is. So how do you play FIFA now, guys? You don't defend, and you chip ball it. That's all you have to do, and you will probably win the majority of your games. Obviously, I lost here today. This guy, he had a good game. He played well, to his credit. Look at that, he put in 27 tackles. He put in 16 shots. He had a good game. He won the game. Fair play to him. Well done to him. Good game, you know. But it's just a boring game. You know, 1-0 after extra time. So boring. Bring us the goals back, EA. Put the defending back to how it was. Let us play with varying styles of FIFA. Let us play with passes, with crosses, with chip through balls, with skill moves, with running, with dribbling, and combining all of those together rather than being forced to play one style of FIFA because you want it to be okay for everybody to be able to defend perfectly, because those without the ability to defend manually were conceding too many goals. It's not my fault if the next person can't defend. It's not your fault if the person you come up against and you beat 7-0 can't defend. Now, that same person that you would have beat 7-0, you'll only beat 1 or 2-0 if you're lucky, because the AI will 100% defend for him. It's not how FIFA should be played. It's not how this game should be. I want the old patch back. You want the old patch back. This is the end of the video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. I'm out. Peace.